Thank you. Thank you. chun chăm riêng chmú Yun ai dọn thay rương lôi ọt chài
Editorial. The UNCTAD elections in Cambodia is the last card played by UNCTAD in order to wash its hands and leave the Cambodian problem unresolved as the Vietnamese remain in Cambodia. The war continues unabated and peace and independence of Cambodia remain far from being restored. 1. Look at the 3-day first of UNCTAD elections, that is on 23rd, 24th, and 25th May 1993. 1. During the first 3 days of UNCTAD elections, Mr. Akashi and UNCTAD had tried hard to mislead public opinion with the figure of hundreds of thousands and millions or such percent of people who have voted. 2. The observers of UNCTAD elections as a whole have agreed that there were more people who have voted on the first day, then on the second day and third day, because A, the population have been forced to vote. B, the elections are a farce which people want to see whether they like it or not. C, the first day was the opening of the elections which UNPAC, Mr. Akashi and the Aung San were doing their utmost to ensure that it was the best show, especially in Phnom Penh, for the television and health reports in the world. Indeed, the puppets and their Vietnamese masters playing the last card have exerted strong pressure and compelled the population to vote for them on the first day so that they would be able to cause trouble to others from the second day onwards. According to the estimation of the observers as a whole, the participation of the people in the voting during the first 3 days is as follows. 1. In Phnom Penh, on the first day, there were no more than 200,000 voters. The second day, as no more than 30,000 voters. And the third day, has no more than 20,000 voters. Therefore, altogether in Phnom Penh, during the first 3 days, there were no more than 250,000 voters. 2. In the provinces. In the provinces, such as Siem Reap, Kampong Thom, Preah Vihea, Phnom Minh Chay, Kampot, Koh Kong, 90% have not voted. In the provinces of Pho San, Kampong Chnang, Kampong Cham, Krati, Tung Trang, the majority of people have not voted. Therefore, in all the provinces of Cambodia, on the first day, no more than 600,000 people have voted. The second day has no more than 300,000 voters. And on the third day, there were no more than 100,000 voters. So, altogether, during the first 3 days, there were no more than 1 million voters in all the provinces. Therefore, during the first 3 days in Phnom Penh and in the provinces, there were no more than 1,215,000 voters. Therefore, we can see that the figures given by the observers are only one-third of those of Mr. Akashi and UNPAC. Mr. Akashi and UNPAC have come up with a misleading figure of more than 3 million or even 4 million voters. That was the election characterized by UNPAC as free and fair. UNPAC has already closed the first phase of its elections and started the second phase, that is, the mobile polling stations aimed at reaching those who have not yet voted and those in remote areas. Actually, as for the mobile polling stations, first, they are organized only as a sheer form to show that UNPAC cares to ensure free and fair elections. Second, UNPAC personnel do not dare to venture to go to the remote areas in the countryside. They would prefer to stay in Phnom Penh and other cities with Vietnamese prostitutes. Third, the Cambodian people do not want to vote as they have themselves experienced the hardship and suffering in the hands of the Vietnamese and their puppets during the past 13 to 14 years of Vietnamese occupation. They also know the true nature of UNPAC during the past 2 years when it has put Cambodia and her people to death. The puppets and their Vietnamese masters and UNPAC cannot force people in the countryside to vote like they have done so in Phnom Penh and other cities. In the countryside, The people who remain at home in the fields, in the forest, do not want to participate in the elections to kill the Cambodian nation and people. Therefore, the mobile polling stations will be a compiled failure. Yet, people are waiting to see Mr. Akashi and every four come up with a figure of how many hundreds of thousands or how many millions of voters through those mobile polling stations. That is indeed a misleading propaganda campaign carried out by Mr. Akashi and UNTAC in order to conceal their dark scam. Even though in the views of many observers, there were less people voting on the second and third day, Mr. Akashi and every four had tried to exaggerate that there were more people voting on the second day and third day. 2. Can the UNTAC elections resolve the Cambodian problem? 1. The above-cited deceiving game remains only with Mr. Akashi and every four. 2. The Cambodian problem in all its aspects remains unresolved as before. As the Cambodian saying goes, they try to wash their hands and relinquish their responsibilities and leave the house, but everything remains in a state of disorder and unwashed. Actually, the old and new Vietnamese forces are present throughout Cambodia. Their puppets continue to rule the country. The SNC and its president, His Royal Highness Samdech Norodom Sihanouk, head of state, have neither power nor role to play. In such a situation, how can the problem of old and new Vietnamese forces be resolved? This is a matter of death or life to the Cambodian people. This is a matter affecting the region as well. 3. The problem of old and new Vietnamese forces has many aspects: military, economic, political, and social. In military aspect, there still are Vietnamese armament, policemen, and militia. In economic and social aspect, the Vietnamese forces have plundered lands, fish, forests, and other things. In political aspect, Akashi has gone so far as to give them every right, including the right to vote. Moreover, now their number has reached nearly 3 million. Tomorrow, 500,000 more will arrive. After tomorrow, 500,000 more. They will certainly reach 5 million, 6 million, 7 million, 8 million, 10 million, because those who are in Cambodia have been legitimized by Akashi and UNTAC. And the UNTAC elections are also another means to legitimize them. What will the Cambodian society become? If people dare to raise their opposition to the Vietnamese presence in Cambodia, Akashi, UNTAC and others resort to human rights and humanitarian grounds to silence the opposition. However, we can see that none of those 10 kinds of human rights and humanitarian rules except to receive a single Vietnamese fall from Cambodia to their countries. The anti-Cambodian people are fully well aware of the problem, with the exception of the traitors and puppets. Actually, the problem of old and new Vietnamese forces affects Cambodia's national security for the fact that those Vietnamese who are scattered throughout the country belong either to the Vietnamese Communist Party or the Vietnamese Communist Youth League, or Vietnamese Workers Association, or Vietnamese Farmers Association, and so on. They have been organized into communist cells, have been armed, and have penetrated deep into the Cambodian society. At stake is indeed Cambodia's national security. In Phnom Penh, in the Mekong, Bassac River, Lower Mekong River, eastern parts of the provinces of Kandang, Takao, Kompot, Preveng, Svai Rieng, Krati, Tan Trang, Ratanakiri, Mundokiri, the Vietnamese are everywhere. No one dare to raise his voice. Another aspect of the same problem has been the signing of treaties and accords between Vietnam and its puppets, including the treaties on the delimitation of frontiers between Vietnam and Cambodia, annexing a large tract of Cambodian territories from Kompot to Ratanakiri. How many square kilometers of Cambodian territories have been annexed by Vietnam? Who are going to resolve this problem? Not only Cambodia's national security is at stake, but also social and demographic changes have been also affected. Look at Kampuchea Krown. The Cambodians, who were the masters of the land, now speak Khmer with Vietnamese accent. Their customs and ways of life have been changed. This is the process which is called the Vietnamization of Cambodia. With the current speed of their arrivals in Cambodia, Cambodia will become not very long like the Kingdom of Champa. Vietnamese has 70 million inhabitants who are facing economic difficulties and even starvation. It can, in a very short time, send 10 million of Vietnamese to Cambodia. In Laos, there are already 50,000 Vietnamese troops and 3 to 4 million of Vietnamese nationals and 200,000 Vietnamese working in the Lao administration from the village up to Vientiane. With 3 to 4 million Vietnamese in Laos and 10 million in Cambodia, Vietnam would become master of the so-called Indochina Federation in a very short time. No one would be concerned for a solution to that problem. The policy of French President Francis Mitterrand and the French Socialist Party, as well as of a number of governments in the world, has been to seek their own interests. Even Cambodia becomes part of Vietnam. They do not care. What they care is their own interests. It is not Un Thap and Attaché and the Aung San who resolve this problem that affects the destiny of Cambodia and her people. The Cambodian nation and people have been struggling for their own survival against the Vietnamese aggressors and their puppets. In this historical moment, the Cambodian nation and people and the resistance forces are of the view that only the plan for national reconciliation of 1st March 1993 of His Royal Highness Samdech Norodom Sihanouk, head of state and president of SNC, can resolve the Cambodian problem. The plan is as follows. First, the formation of a provisional government of national reconciliation with Samdech as the head of state and prime minister. Second, the representatives of the four Cambodian parties participate in the provisional government of national reconciliation as deputy prime ministers. Third, the setting up of a unified national army comprising units drawn from the armed forces of the four Cambodian parties. The plan is the only way that we restore peace and independence in Cambodia. Voice of the Front of Great National Unity of Cambodia. 27th May 1993.
Following is the commentary entitled, What is the reality of Akandi's claim of great success of UNTAC elections with 90% of people casting their ballots? Can UNTAC elections bring peace and independence and national contribution in Cambodia? Are not UNTAC elections spreading the Vietnamese war of aggression in Cambodia? During the past few days of UNTAC elections, the intent in and out of UNTAC have been trying hard to carry out their propaganda campaign about such or such percent of the people have voted. Akashi, the head of UNTAC, has for his part claimed that 90% of the people have voted and that the elections are the great success. Yes, observers, the on the first day, there was quite a number of people voting in the Phnom Penh and in the other big cities. On the second day, the voters were less than on the first day. On the third day, the number of voters is even less than on that of the second day. Altogether, there were no more than 40% of the people who had voted during the first 3 days, according to the estimation of many observers. The Cambodian people, either in Phnom Penh or in the countryside, there were approximately 1 million people who had voted. That is roughly 25% of the total more than 4 million voters registered by UNTAC. Therefore, Akashi's claim is an exaggerated figure, 3 times more than the reality. According to international statistics, if the voters are less than 30% of the population, the elections are not valid. As for the UNTAC elections in Cambodia, the international observers actually say that there were less than 40% of the population of the Cambodian people, whether in Scotland or in the countryside, is only a figure of 25%. Why Akashi was in a hurry and in a seamless manner to come up with so high a figure? It is indeed his attempt to conceal the true and bad image of himself and of UNTAC, who have violated and destroyed the Paris Agreement of 23rd October 1991, and who have stubbornly organized the elections to kill the Cambodian nation and people. The most and urgent question is whether such a fast election organized by UNTAC can achieve peace, independence, and national contribution in Cambodia as spelled out in the objectives of the Paris Agreement? The answer is an absolute no. The objectives of the Paris Agreement clearly specify that foreign forces must be withdrawn from Cambodia and not allowed to return to the country, and that Cambodia must be restored as a peaceful, independent, neutral, and united country where the Cambodian people enjoy their right to self-determination. The Cambodian nation and people are of the view that only the elections organized in a neutral political environment in accordance with the provisions of the Paris Agreement can peace, independence, and national confederation be restored in Cambodia. Akashi's elections are not held in accordance with the provisions of the Paris Agreement. UNTAC has actually failed to implement the seven main provisions of the Paris Agreement. 1. UNPAC has not allowed the ANC to play its role as the unit legitimate body and source of authority in Cambodia during the transitional period. 2. UNPAC has not implemented its mandate on the control and verification of the Vietnamese forces. UNPAC has even promulgated electoral law allowing the Vietnamese officer to vote. UNPAC has also permitted the continued flow of Vietnamese nationals into Cambodia every day, whose number has now reached nearly 3 million. 3. UNPAC has not exercised its direct control of the 5 major administrative spheres. 4. UNPAC has failed to create a neutral political environment which is necessary to organize the elections. On the contrary, a climate of insecurity prevails as a result of the intensification of the act of political terrorism committed by the Vietnamese and their public before and during the UNPAC election. The Cambodian nation and people know full well that such Akashi elections will not bring peace to Cambodia. On the contrary, they only add to the fuel of the Vietnamese war of aggression in Cambodia, as the fundamental problems remain unresolved as was the case in 1979. The Cambodian people and the international observers as a whole are of the view that the solution that deals with peace, independence, and national reconciliation must be in conformity with the aspirations of the Cambodian people as well as the wishes of the people in South Asia and in the world at large. Those aspirations and wishes are already described in the provisions of the Paris Agreement. They are specifically mentioned in the terms of the National Constitution of the Square and its conduct, the head of state and president of the SNP. The Cambodian nation and people do not want UNPAC elections organized to serve the Cambodian nation and people. They want the implementation of the plan for national reconciliation of which were harnessed from the government. That is, first, the formation of a four-party provisional government of national reconciliation, which conducts as the head of state and prime minister. Secondly, the representatives of the four Cambodian parties participate in the provisional government as deputy prime minister. Thirdly, the setting up of a unified national army under the command of Samdak, comprising units drawn from the armed forces of the four Cambodian parties. Samdak's plan is the only way to restore peace, independence, neutrality, and unity of Cambodia and national reconciliation. Samdak's plan is fully in accord with the Paris Agreement and entirely responds to the aspirations of the Cambodian people as well as the wishes of the people in Asia, in Southeast Asia, and in the world at large. We have been listening to the commentary of Akashi. What is the reality of Akashi's claim of great success of UNPAC elections, with 90% of people casting their ballot? Can UNPAC elections bring peace and independence and national reconciliation in Cambodia? Are not UNPAC elections spreading the Vietnamese war of aggression in Cambodia?
Thank you. Ngày 26 tháng 5, Uruguay và Indonesia thuộc thành phần đồng nhất Liên Hợp Quốc.
Thank you.
ជំរាបឈ្មោះភ្លើងសង្គ្រាមរលត់លឹះប្រាំងតែអូនតាក់ព្រោះ